Ransomware is targeting the ESXi hypervisor. The Reddit breach was caused by employee credential phishing, and this new ransomware is targeting Linux. All that coming up now on ThreatWire. Greetings! I am Shannon Morse, and this is ThreatWire for February 14th, 2023. Happy Valentine's Day! This is your summary of the threats to our security, privacy, and internet freedom. Let's go ahead and jump right into the news this week. VMware ESXi, or ESXi as apparently a lot of people like to call it, is a hypervisor for cloud hosts and enterprises. It runs using its own operating system on server hardware and basically acts as a consolidator for hardware resources. This is a Type 1 hypervisor, while a Type 2 would be defined as something like VirtualBox, which runs in an application inside another operating system. Now, in the past week or so, many attacks have been targeting ESXi with ransomware, even though this vulnerability was patched 2 years ago. This was CVE-2021-21974 and is a heap-based buffer overflow in OpenSLP listed with a critical severity rating. OpenSLP is a network discovery tool that's built into ESXi. Now, the known attack vector, according to VMware, was if an actor residing in the same network segment as ESXi had access to port 427, they could trigger the buffer overflow, and this would result in remote code execution. VMware patched it in February of 2021, but of course, not all installations have been updated to protect against this attack. So suddenly, tons of vulnerable servers were hit, leading to the computer emergency response teams in several countries reporting the campaign activity with over 3,800 infected servers found. The ransomware encrypts CM files and it adds the .args or args file extension to the end of locked files, so the campaign has been dubbed ESXi args. The ransomware is not perfect though, and researchers at your group tech team have successfully decrypted some of the active victims. The victims are told to pay up to 2.01 Bitcoin or about $45,000 USD to receive an encryption key, and data exfiltration does not appear to be a factor in these attacks. Shortly after this news, the U.S. Cybersecurity and Infrastructure Security Agency released a free script to decrypt victims on their GitHub, which automates the process found by your group tech team. Technically, this script rebuilds the virtual machine from unencrypted flat files. A few days after CISA released this script, the attackers released an update to the malware, which targets more files and makes decryption more challenging. They also updated the ransomware note to request that victims contact them via talks to get the wallet information for payment. Updated stats show that over 1,200 have been infected with the updated variant, and over 1,100 of those are reinfections. So you really can't depend on the CISA tool to fix this. Some new reports are saying that some infected servers have already disabled SLP service, so it's possible the attackers are using some other vulnerabilities as well. So if you have not already patched to the most up-to-date software, do so immediately. Admins can also isolate their servers, reinstall the hypervisor, apply the patches, and block access via firewall. Reddit disclosed a security incident last week that occurred due to an employee's login credentials getting phished. In this breach, an attacker was able to access source code, internal documents, dashboards, business systems, and contact details for hundreds of Reddit employees. Production systems and user accounts and password data was not accessed, according to a post about the incident. Reddit became aware of the phishing campaign on February 5th when an attacker sent out prompts to employees to a website that cloned their intranet gateway, attempting to steal employee login credentials and the two-factor authentication tokens. They successfully obtained some creds, leading to internal access. Employees impacted included former and current, as well as some advertiser information. The employee who was phished self-reported, and the security team removed the rogue access almost immediately. While Reddit has no indication of user accounts being accessed, they reminded users in the post to enable two-factor authentication and use good password hygiene online. Now, we don't know for sure, based on this post, what form of multi-factor authentication Reddit is requiring its employees to use, but this does sound like they are not requiring hardware-based authentication using FIDO or similar with a key such as a YubiKey. That means that employees could be susceptible to authentication or 2FA fatigue, wherein they rely on a push prompt to authenticate and eventually they just choose yes because they get tired of seeing the pop-up. Or they may rely on OTP, such as 6-digit codes, which are sent to an authenticator app, which can be stolen and copied by an attacker. We have seen many of these kinds of attacks over the last year. I've reported on many of them, showing that using hardware-based authentication can be a crucial requirement for employees going into the new year. Biggest of shoutouts to my Patreon supporters, especially my golden s'mores and their fur babies, for making this show possible since we do not have ads on the show at all, except for Patreon. And a huge thank you to Eric, Katie, Keith, Dan, Gabe, and Sarah for being a part of the s'mores at patreon.com/ShannonMorse. That's my new Patreon page for the show, where I will be posting all of the perks for patrons, including early access to this very video. My YouTube channel is youtube.com/ShannonMorse for everything from tech reviews to security tutorials, like my newest video about my favorite password managers for 2023. And don't forget to like and subscribe to Hack5 as well. Let's go ahead and finish out today's episode with my last top story, all about Linux ransomware. A new exploit tracked as CVE-2023-0669 is being actively exploited to allow attackers to gain remote code execution via the Go Anywhere MFT file transfer tool developed by Fortra. The vulnerability is a zero-day, and the Clop ransomware gang has claimed that they are the group behind the attacks, which so far have allowed them to steal data from 130 organizations. According to reports, the hacking group targeted servers vulnerable to this bug over a 10-day period, and they used the unauthorized access to move laterally through networks of victims. Huntress posted about this event as well, stating the potential responsible party may be a group called TA505 due to similarities in activity and deployment mechanisms used in the attacks. Fortra issued emergency security updates for the tool, and around the same time, a proof of concept exploit was posted online by a security researcher. The group using Clop ransomware has been on a productive streak lately, as a new Linux variant has also been spotted in the wild. This ELF executable is flawed, though, allowing for decryption of locked files, according to researchers at SentinelOne, who made a decryptor for this new variant. Research shows this new Linux variant is missing several of the features of its counterpart Windows version, but it's likely that we will see updated ransomware in the near future. It's currently not detected in VirusTotal, so it's entirely possible the threat actor has not had a need to improve obfuscation or evasiveness yet, all according to SentinelOne researcher Antonis Terafos. So will we see new variants in 2023? Most likely, yeah. And the fact that a Linux version now exists tells us the group behind these attacks is now targeting more than just Windows operating systems. I'm Shannon Morse, and I will see you on the internet.